Hello everyone, welcome to Vlogmas Day 8/7. So yesterday I just had work and I was so tired after work that I literally didn't do anything but sleep in my bed. But now I'm at work, so let me go clock in.
I made her open the gate again today.
Anyways, like I was saying earlier, I did not film anything yesterday because I took a nap after work and then I woke up at like 9 and then I was like, the day's over. And then I went back to bed, so. But we're on break now, and I don't know what we should eat for lunch. Picking up Starbucks yet again, what a surprise. I like how they wrote my name like this. It looks funny. So we decided to go get Burger King. Also, funny random story. So me and my coworker really like animals, and the other day we saw a stray dog just running around. So we decided to try to rescue it during our lunch break, but it kept running away from us. And then we realized that it belonged to the house that was a few houses down, and it had signs that said beware of dog. So there was that.
What kind of car is this? I'm intrigued.
Say something!
I'm shy!
Say something!
Oh my god.
Rachel has something to say.
What's our bit?
What do you mean?
We're on the way to Burger King!
Oh my god.
When's the last time you had Burger King? Let us know in the comments.
It's giving 2007 influencer. I would also just like to add, I have not had Burger King in years, but there is one so conveniently close to us that I think it's time. Yeah.
Not the Burger King B-roll, babe.
Not me in my Vlogmas uniform with the vlog camera going to Burger King. I cannot.
So clean in here.
We secured the goods. I feel like getting Burger King is kind of camp. Everything about Burger King is camp. Not me doing a Burger King haul. This is the height of camp. So we got some nuggets. Rachel got the Impossible Whopper because she's vegan. Here you go. Also, gotta get the fries. She only says thank you when the camera's on. And I got the classic Whopper. Why is this kind of big? It's like the size of my face. You guys, I got a water delivery and they gave me a new machine. Kind of left it out here. I'm not trying to be a Karen, but I don't even really know how to install this. I hope I just plug it in. I don't know. They said they were gonna install it for me. I just want to say I've been eating out so much, absolutely vile, and also a huge waste of money. So I definitely need to get back on my eating at home grind and packing my lunches. I know I will Postmate again later for sure. So I Instacarted myself some groceries, which is this delivery app basically for groceries. It saves me time. I'll just order it on my way home from work, and then that way, like, by the time I'm home, it'll be like ready. Okay, so basically the shopper who bought stuff for me grabbed me moldy grapes. So thank you for that. That's going straight to the trash. I don't even know if you guys care what groceries I get, but like I just enjoy watching what other people get. And then I'll kind of explain like what I make from it, even though it's kind of obvious. And not my Roomba going off. Quiet on set, Miss Roomba. Yeah, that's what I thought. Okay, provolone cheese. I don't know why, but I think this is my favorite cheese. The texture, the tanginess, like, just fabulous. Next thing I always get is blueberries. Blueberries just hit, and then I think you need to eat, like, some type of fruit so you don't, you know, die. I also get Swiss cheese. This is for when I'm being, like, less disgusting, and I'll use, like, a skinny version of the cheese. Also, baby spring mix. Love this. I always put this in my sandwiches, or if I make a bowl, I'll just sneak some in because I literally do not eat any greens. What else did I get? I got some deli meat, turkey, super basic. We got, oh no, great. The banana's already falling apart. We got some chicken breast. So I usually air fry this and I'll make like a rice bowl and I'll add some veggies to it, super simple. If I don't eat a chicken bowl, I will have a turkey breast burger. Love Miss Turkey Breast. Big fan of her work. Also, I feel like you could crumble it and add it to a rice bowl too, and that's good. Dave's bread. I love this for my sandwiches. It just tastes so good and it's healthy for you. I also get the same brand, but burger buns for the turkey burgers. Okay, so the next thing is kind of like little snacks or treats for myself. So I always get this Bertolli frozen pasta. I hate like most frozen foods, but this one just slaps and it's so good. And it's so easy. You just throw it in the pan, you put on for like 10 to 15 minutes and it's done. It's over. Dinner is prepared. Bone apple teeth. And this one, my little snack to myself, some Ruffles. I love the hot wings flavored, but they don't have that anymore. So I have to settle for barbecue hot wings. Ruffles help. And last but not least, my favorite treat of them all. I love mochi. This is the double chocolate one. Honestly, all the flavors are good, so I'm not gonna recommend like a specific flavor, but bone apple teeth, baby. I'm gonna put these groceries away before they start going bad, so I'll be right back. I moved the squishmallows into my room, so we're redoing the whole apartment. I hate my apartment right now. We'll talk about that tomorrow because I cannot deal right now. Also, I put the new water machine here for now, but I don't think I like it there anymore. So I have to find like a new area I want to put that in. Okay, so I kind of want to talk to you guys about how I got my job. You guys were kind of very intrigued when I posted my vlog yesterday and when I posted my first one about my job. So I thought I would kind of just tell you the process of getting into like the social media influencer or marketing world. So I'll tell you my journey and kind of like a quick tip or two. When I was at FITM, which is the Fashion Institute of Merchandise and Marketing in Los Angeles, I studied merchandise marketing, but I emphasized in marketing, which later in your years, you can kind of go towards merchandising or marketing. Like you can pick a specific major. Anyway, so I thought I was going to be a buyer. And then when I spoke to my advisor, she said most buyers are in their like 30s. And I started college super young. So I was like, oh, well, I'm going to have to wait a while. So in the meantime, I was like, okay, well, I might as well get like a marketing job and stuff like that before I'm taken seriously. So while I was in school, my advisor suggested to me that I work retail because no one will let you be a buyer unless you've had retail experience. So she suggested having an internship and a retail job at the same time while going to school to even like get my application in the door for even attempting to be a buyer. I said yes. So at that time I was working at the Grove and I was working at Topshop, which is so funny to think about, literally making breadcrumbs. And I had an internship. So first I interned for my school and then through networking, I started interning for this PR firm. And when I interned at that PR firm, I got connected to LA Fashion Week. Through there, I networked. I met an editorial stylist. I started working for him. I got a job there. So then I thought I was gonna be a stylist. I hated that side of the industry and just the people I was around. So I quit that. My last quarter, I noticed like a lot of people that were in my major had like great job. I'm smart. I'm great. The teachers always use my projects as an example. I should just apply now. So I started applying to jobs in my last quarter instead of like trying to find an internship. And I actually got a job. I first worked at this streetwear brand and I did all their marketing. So nothing social, just like their business plan, their advertising, their budgeting, literally everything business. So that was really fun. I was getting paid really, really well, but it was a startup. So I had zero benefits. So then my mom was like,
get like a real job with like benefits
and blah, 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 blah. And I was like, oh, I guess you're right. So then I started searching. So something I've always been passionate about was makeup and beauty and skincare. I guess like I've been scared to express that side of myself. I low key like always wanted a job at Sephora and stuff, but I guess I was just too scared. Obviously now I'm an adult living in Los Angeles. So I'm like, I can do whatever the hell I want. Also like just seeing like big beauty boy influencers and stuff, it kind of like inspired me. So I was like, okay, like time to like dip my toe in the beauty industry. Also, I was friends with so many social media influencers, so I just knew how to grow a brand followers and how to blow up really quickly. Like I just got it. And this is something I learned from like street smarts and just being around my friends. Obviously having that college education to have that like technical aspect. So it was kind of match made in heaven. I applied to this job, found through my school's like college Facebook group. And I was like, you know what? Like, I'll just like apply. When I showed up to the interview, I genuinely didn't think I was gonna get the job at all. Everyone was so professional, and there was like 6 people interviewing me at once, and it was really intimidating. And for some reason, they liked me enough to offer me an internship in a sense. It was like a very, very entry level job. And I kind of was like, you know what? Let me just like show them what I can do and kind of prove myself. I joined their team, and then within the first week, they were so shook by me, they offered me like a real salary. Then after 6 months, I got a title raise, and then a year later, I got a major title raise, and I've just been there ever since. Advice of how to break into that industry is definitely networking. Like, utilize your resources. Look online. Look who these people are that already work for the brand. DM them. Honestly, like, I don't think it's that weird if someone's trying to break into the industry and they were asking me if there's any internships or stuff. As a society and as people, we should all help each other. Whenever I hear of any internships or any job opportunities, I definitely let people know. If you don't ask for help, you're not going to receive it. And I feel like people genuinely like to help people and be mentors, especially in LA. That's at least my experience. I feel like so many people help me. For example, even YouTube, I made it during the pandemic, and then like my friends mentor me so much. Like literally, like Alicia and Remy go so hard, giving me like the equipment, like literally giving me video ideas, literally like being like, okay, what do you need? Like, let's think of video idea. Let's film this. Let's do this. Let's do this together. You know what I mean? Like, I feel like if you don't ask for help, you're never gonna like grow, you know? But that's just my little advice to you guys. But honestly, it's a really boring day for me. It's just like a regular work day. I'm just gonna sit on the couch, literally veg out, catch up on my shows. Love you guys so much. And if you haven't subscribed, I would really appreciate it if you subscribed. We are growing. Thank you for joining. I appreciate you guys so much, and see you guys tomorrow. Bye.